Welcome students. Now we are going to learn the second part of the lesson, Kingdom Animalia. In the previous segment, we have learned about the classification of Kingdom Animalia up to phylum Echinodermata. Up to phylum Echinodermata were invertebrates. Now we are going to discuss about phylum Chordata. Hemi means half. Chorda means string. Hemichordata, before it was considered as a subphylum of Chordata, but now it is regarded as an independent phylum of invertebrata, because all the characteristic features of this phylum is very close to Echinodermata. Animals of this group possess characters of invertebrates as well as chordate, and so they become the connecting link between both. This phylum consists of small group of worm-like soft marine organisms. Mostly they are tubiculous. Tubiculous means they are tube-like structures, and they are commonly called as acorn worm or tongue worm. So they are exclusively marine. The body is classified into proboscis, collar and trunk. So this is proboscis, this is collar and trunk region. In proboscis, buccal diverticulum is present. Digestive tract is complete. It starts with mouth and ends with anus. And respiration is by branchial portion of the pharynx. Vascular system is open type. There is no blood vessels like arteries or veins. So excretion is by a single proboscis gland or glomerulus, which is situated in the proboscis region of the organism. Nervous system is primitive type, and the reproduction is sexual. Sexes are separate and exhibit sexual mode of reproduction. Fertilization is external. Development is indirect with a free swimming Tornaria larva. This is the example for Hemichordata balanoglossus. Other examples are Sacoglossus, Ticordero flava, that is Indian Hemichordata found in Cruiseroy Island in Tamil Nadu. Phylum Chordata, and it is again divided into three subphylums, namely Urochordata, Cephalochordata and Vertebrata. Chordata is the largest phylum with the most familiar group of animals such as amphibians, reptiles, birds, etc. as well as the uncommon forms like Lancet or Amphioxus, this is Amphioxus, and tunicates, which are Ascidian. All the chordate possess certain common features. They are, first one, presence of an elongated rod-like notochord. So this gray color line is representing the notochord. It will be present throughout the lifetime of the lancet as well as lampreys. In adult vertebrates, it is partially or completely replaced by the backbone or the vertebral column. So this is the notochord. So this lies below the nerve cord. So above this notochord is present the nerve cord. And this nerve cord will become the spinal cord in the higher vertebrates. Second one, dorsal nerve cord. Dorsal nerve cord lies above the notochord, and it serves to integrate and coordinate all the body function. So they represent the nervous system. In higher chordates, the anterior end of the nerve cord gets enlarged. And forms the brain, and the posterior end becomes the spinal cord. This is protected inside the vertebral column. The third feature is that pharyngeal gill slits or clefts. So they are present in the pharynx, wall of the pharynx. They appear during the developmental stage of all the chordates. In the primitive forms, in the aquatic forms, the pharyngeal gill slits are vascular and they serve the purpose of respiration, and they act as gills. Whereas in the terrestrial or the higher chordates, these gill slits appear in the developmental stage, in the embryonic stage, and they will disappear later. So besides this, all the chordates will have some common features, like they are bilaterally symmetric, they are diploblastic, and coelom will be present, true coelom will be present with organ system level of organization, and they possess a post-anal tail, and they have closed circulatory system with ventral myogenic heart except amphioxus. So amphioxus does not possess the myogenic heart. What do you mean by myogenic heart? The heartbeat is initiated by the muscles of the heart. Differences between the chordata and non-chordata. Chordata, notochord is found in the embryonic stage, and it is replaced by the vertebral column in the adult. Here, notochord is absent. In non-chordate, notochord is absent. Central nervous system in chordata is dorsal in position, hollow and single. Whereas central nervous system in non-chordata is ventral in position, solid and double. Chordata possess pharyngeal gill slits. They are absent in non-chordates. In chordata, the heart is ventrally placed. In non-chordates, the heart is dorsally placed. If it is present, it is dorsally placed. Chordates will have a post-anal tail, where it is absent in non-chordates. Subphylum Urochordata. Uro means tail. They are exclusively marine. A notochord is only restricted to the tail region of the larval stage, and they are absent in the adult, that is retrogressive metamorphosis. They are present in the larval stage. As they develop, they disappear. Adult forms are sac-like tunicates, and coelom is absent. It has an atrial cavity. So atrial cavity is present surrounding the pharynx. So notochord is present in the tail region of the larval stage alone, and they are absent in the adult. They degenerate and they are absent in the adult. Alimentary canal is complete and circulatory system is of open type. Dorsal tubular nerve cord is present only in the larval stage, and a single ganglion is present in the dorsal side. Mostly they are hermaphrodite, and development is indirect, having the larval stage, which is free swimming tadpole larva with chordate characteristic features, and retrogressive metamorphosis is seen in the adult. Example, Ascidia, Salpa and Dolliolum. Subphylum Cephalochordata. Cephalo means head. Cephalochordates are marine organism. They are found in the shallow water. They are small fish-like coelomate forms. They have the tubular dorsal nerve cord and pharyngeal gill slits. Adults have the notochord, which are extending from the head to tail. They have closed type of circulatory system without a heart. They do not have heart, and excretion is effected through the protonephridia. Sexes are separate. Fertilization external, and they have a free swimming larva. Example, Bronchiostoma. Subphylum Vertebrata. So vertebrae means backbone. Notochord is present in the embryonic stage. In adult, it is replaced by the vertebral column. They have the cranium or the skull. All the vertebrates are chordates, but all the chordates are not vertebrates. Subphylum Vertebrata is divided into two divisions. They are Agnatha and Gnathostomata. Agnatha include jawless fishes. Jawless fishes are aquatic, and the notochord will be persistent in the adult. Notochord will be present in the adult. They have no pad appendages, and it has only one class, namely Cyclostomata. The second division is Gnathostomata, and it is divided into two superclasses, namely Pisces are the jarred fishes and Tetrapoda. Tetrapoda is again classified into four classes, namely Amphibia, Reptilia, Aves and Mammals. Superclass Pisces is classified into class chondrichthys, which is comprises of the cartilaginous fishes, and ostrichthys, which is comprising of the bony fishes. Class cyclostoma. Cyclo means circle. So all the members of this class, they are primitive, they are poikilothermic. Poikilothermic means they will change their body temperature according to the environmental temperature. And some are fish-like. The body is slender and eel-like. Mouth is circular and it is jawless. That is very important characteristic features. They have gill slits from 6 to 15 pairs on both the side of the pharyngeal region. Head and the brain are poorly developed and fins are unpaired in the case of cyclostoma. Stomach is absent. Heart is two-chambered. Exoskeleton is made up of cartilage. Kidneys are mesonephric. In cephalocaudate, we have seen protonephridia. It is here mesonephridia. And fertilization is external and the development is indirect with the larval stage called amoecete. They migrate from the seawater to the freshwater and freshwater to the seawater for breeding. Movement from the marine water to freshwater is called as anadromous. After spawning, within few days, again the larvae metamorphoses and return back to the ocean or the seawater. So example for this is Petromyzon or lamprey or mixing hagfish. So this is the lamprey and hagfish. See the mouth, which is circular and jawless. The superclass species is again divided into chondrichthys and ostrichthys. So chondrichthys are the cartilaginous fishes. They are elasmobranchs in other name. Ostriches are bony fishes. They are teleost. So they are cartilaginous fishes. They are bony fishes. They have the heterocercal tail, whereas here the bony fishes have homocercal tail. They have the placoid scales on their body. They have three types of scales like cycloid, ganoid and tenoid scale. So in the cartilaginous fishes, cloaca is present. Cloaca is present in the cartilaginous fishes, whereas it is absent in bony fishes. Operculum is absent here, whereas the bony fishes will have the operculum, which will lead into the gill slits. They don't have the swim bladder, whereas they have the swim bladder. Excretory product is urea in the case of cartilaginous fishes, whereas it is ammonia in the case of bony fishes. Cartilaginous fishes are viviparous. They are either viviparous or oviparous. Here the males will have the clasper or the organs for reproduction. Whether here the bony fishes do not possess clasper. Example for the chondrichthys: scoliodont, sharkfish, trigon or stingray, pristis or sawfish. Example for bony fishes or ostrichthys: Cutlam, labio, exocetus, hippocampus, etc. Next we have the class amphibia, which comes under the super class tetrapoda. The tetrapoda means four legs. They are four legged organism. They are amphibious. They can live both on land and in water. Body is divided into head and trunk. The skull is dicondylic. Kidney is mesonephric. They are poikilothermic. The tail may or may not be present. The skin is smooth. Alimentary canal, urinary tract as well as reproductive tract will open in a common chamber, which is called as cloaca. Fertilization is external and the young ones are called tadpole. So here you can see the life cycle. So eggs, which are hatching out into tadpole. Tadpole will grow the limbs to become the tailed frog and frog. Kidneys are mesonephric. Heart is three-chambered. They are oviparous and the development is indirect, having the tadpole larva. Example: bufo or toad, rana, frog, hyala, tree frog, salamander. Next class is reptilia. They are creeping or crawling animals. They are mostly terrestrial. Their skin will be dry and rough without any glands. Scales and scutes may be present. Example: crocodile. Heart is three-chambered. RBCs are nucleated in the reptilia, whereas they are not nucleated in the mammals. Kidneys are metanephric kidneys. Cranial nerves, 12 pairs of cranial nerves are present. Cloaca is present, which is a common opening for urinogenital system as well as the digestive system. They are oviparous and the eggs are macrolecithal eggs. Macrolecithal means the yolk will be larger than the albumin. Class apes, they are bipedal. They walk with two legs. The body is feathered. They are warm-blooded animal or homeotherms. Uropygial or preen glands are present with which they can clean and keep the feathers fresh and clean. Beak will present and they will lack teeth. There is no teeth in them. Alimentary canal will possess crop and gizzard. They are crop is the stomach region to store the food and gizzard will help in the grinding of the seeds and the nuts. Respiration is through lungs. Heart is four-chambered. Kidneys are metanephric and there are 12 pairs of cranial nerves. Sexual dimorphism is seen. Male and female are separate. Reproduce by laying the eggs. Oviparous. The last class, mammalia. So mammalia are warm-blooded animal, WARM, and their body is hairy. They possess mammary glands, oil glands and sweat glands are present on the skin. The skull is dicondylic. They have two orbits for the eye in their skull. And cranial nerves are 12 in numbers, 12 pairs. 12 pairs of cranial nerves are present. Respiration is through the lungs. Heart is four-chambered. And they have viviparous giving birth to the young ones. Placenta will be present where the young ones are developed. The exoskeleton includes horny epidermal horns, spine, scales, claws, nails, hooves, bony dermal plates. Teeth is present. They are ticodont or heterodont and diplodont. Tico means they are made up of horny calcareous material. Hetero means they will have two different types of teeth like canine, incisors, molars and premolars. Diplodont, they will have two sets of teeth in their lifetime. So ears, external ear or pinnae is present. Mature RBC lack nucleus and they are biconcave in shape. Kidneys are metanephric and ureotelic. They are homeotherms. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal.